So hey, my name is Jamie Pollock. We're here with Susan. We're teaching her how to scan. So first off, I'm going to go down here to the launch pad and open it up. And inside of the launch pad, I'm looking for the image capture application. So I'm going to click and open the image capture application. We'll notice in the left column under shared, here we see our scanner. So there it is. I have already gone over and put the paper on the printer, but as we did that, we did notice in the corner there was a little arrow saying this is the top corner, so we know which way to add the paper. Now, one thing about image capture is that if we don't see the side column, it could be collapsed. Oops, I pushed the wrong button. That's okay. So if the details are hidden, we're going to hit the Show Details button here. So that just opens that back up. But now that I've done it, it should stay that way for you. It's going to run the overview of the scan to see what's on the scanner. If I change what's on there, like if I take that paper off and put another piece of paper on, I have to hit the Overview button to re-scan what's on there so that what's on the screen matches what's on the printer or what's on the scanner bed. Also notice these little lines with the blue dots around it. These are called handles, and this says this is what I want to scan, right? So this is the area I want to scan, right? Or maybe I only want to scan the first top part of the page, right? So this selects the area that I want. Maybe I want this whole page, right? If it's a whole page, maybe I want the whole thing. Okay. If I don't like what this is around, I could always hit delete and get rid of it. But then I need to click and drag across again to again highlight or select the area I want scanned. But I need that dotted line with the blue dots around it. Down the left side, I can decide whether I want to be black and white or color. We normally just always leave it color. Even if it's black and white, just let it be color. Resolution, for normal stuff, 75 is just fine. Maybe bump it up to 100 if you want it to be a little crisper. Where do I want to scan it to? Do I want to put it in my pictures folder or drop it on my desktop? Do I want to attach it to an email immediately? Okay. Do I want to put it into my photos application? Maybe I'm scanning pictures. So I can decide where I want to scan it to. This one we're just going to go ahead and drop. Well, let's go ahead and make an email out of it. So we're going to attach this one to an email. What do I want to call it? We're going to call it test scan so we know what's up. And then right here, do I want it to be a JPEG or a PDF? Those are the two you would normally choose from here. So a PDF would be a document, a piece of paper. A JPEG would be an image or a picture. You probably don't need the other ones. You know, those are the two that I would suggest you stick with. So we're going to make this one as a PDF, right? And by the way, combine into a single document. If I have multiple pages, I could actually scan page, 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 but have it all show up in one final document. So that's this checkbox right here, combine into the single document. Now that I've decided my resolution, where I want to put it, what I want to call it, and what the format is, I'm just going to come down here and push the scan button. So now we hear the scanner scanning it in. And notice it immediately creates an email message, puts the attachment on it, and now all I have to do is address it and hit the send button, and away it goes.